Sorry guys, we had a little bit of a, we lost signal there for a second. As you can see, we've joined our two little teenage boys having a play fight in front of us. Oh, it's actually two girls. That's quite unusual. So remember guys, all your questions on email to questions@wildearth.tv and on Twitter, just #SafariLive. So the eddies actually spread out all around us. We unluckily just missed them when they came down to drink it at the dam. But you can see they've got wet feet, a bit of mud on them, and now they're spreading out while they forage. All seem in a very good mood after the rain today. Let's just move a little bit forward. Notice when we start up around animals like elephants, you want to let the vehicle run for a few seconds. It's just to get them used to the noise and show that you're not threatening and moving directly and quickly into them. Also, we don't try not rev the engine or make any particular noise. All those type of things could be seen as threatening noises if you're an elephant. Hello. So those two are still having a great game at the back there. You can see this one right here closest to us just shook her head a little bit at us, and it's just telling us it's a big animal and very strong, so we mustn't push our limits too far. So we always respect the animals, and the animals told us to stop and not come any closer, so that's what we'll do. Now in a situation like that, if we'd started the vehicle and revved and driven away quickly, it would have actually enticed the elephants to chase us or charge us. So in a lot of situations, the best thing to do is just to sit still and quietly, and there we go, moves off. Okay guys, we're gonna link across to Scott. He's found some cats, so over to you, Scotty. Hi guys, welcome back. As you can see, these Ellies are still playing, having a great old time. The one seems to want to eat, and the other one just seems to want to harass it. And being bigger, it seems to win. Actually, as we've moved a little bit further down the road, there's a lot more elephants around. You didn't realize. Actually, almost all the way around us. There's a nice little one up in front of us. The little guy. He got a bit of a fright earlier. He got left behind by his mom and came scurrying across the road. Our local landscapers here at Juma. Very important part that they play in the ecosystem by pushing down trees and disrupting water holes. Sorry guys, just make sure we don't get in the way of the fight. So every time an elephant pushes down a tree, he creates a sort of micro ecosystem for insects, for... Oh, we're behind you. We're behind you. You two so busy arguing with each other, you forgot we were here. Uh-uh. silly elephants. Just gonna move. Oh, no, running around behind us. Okay, that's fine. Okay, so as I was saying, very important. Elephants are one of the few wild mammal species that they have the ability to change their environment. In doing so, they create much bigger grasslands. And so the removal of elephants, or if elephants move from an area due to drought or because of human persecution, the area becomes a lot more forested again. This guy's having, is he playing with a dead stick up there? So he's just playing there, and that's definitely not to eat, very old, dry piece of wood. Oh. Do you love spending time with Eddies? No. Never a dull moment. There's always something going on.
Each one has so much character.
Definitely. I think the one who ran off behind us is quite happy. Now she can actually eat without being harassed by this young bull here. Although I think he looks like he's off to go. No? Just gonna... amazing watching their trunk. He literally flits between the different plants on the ground and chooses the exact one he wants. It's also quite strange to see with the ellies in certain areas eat different things. So you can see there's this very light colored tree the elephant's walking in behind, and it's called a silver terminalia or a silver cluster leaf. And in this area, because it's such a great area, they don't eat it at all. But in other parts of South Africa, like northern KwaZulu-Natal, they absolutely flatten it, and it's one of their favorite trees. They don't have as many high-value tree species or grass species in that area as they do here. So it's very interesting that the elephant's diet will change completely in different areas. Let's try to move around a little bit, see if we can get a nice view of the rest of the group sitting in the shade. There they are. So I think what we're going to do is we're actually going to carry on, see what else we can find. Unless you guys would like to stay with the elephants, please let me know at on Twitter at hashtag Safari Live, or email us at questions@wildearth.tv. Oh, there's a whole bunch more down in the drainage line. There must be close on 20, 25 elephants in the area. Good afternoon, Tim. Welcome on Drive with us this afternoon. Tim would like to know whether female ellies spar for control of the herd. I think with the females that... Oh, it's a very interesting question. I'm not 100% sure on that one. As far as I know, the matriarch, or the oldest female, generally takes over, and it is a hereditary to a degree that elephants can, but with elephants there's always a lot of argument about that type of stuff. But I would say there might be a little bit of that, sparring for control, or testing the boundaries of the other individual members. but I'm not actually 100% sure. Down there. So move a little bit forward, see what the other. Okay, guys, seems like you'd like to stay with the Ellie, so that's what we'll do. I'm just going to try and get a better view of. There's some others, it seemed like there was some action going down in this drainage line. Let's see what's going on here. There's a little boy. And see, actually, if you look carefully in between his front legs, there's a white dot. I'll wait for Brian's just going to zoom in a little bit there. And see, that's a big tick that's feeding off his blood. Won't really have any adverse effects. Oh, two little boys now going at it. Now they're nearly getting to the edge where, as you can see, they're right on the edge of the herd, where the females will actually push them away from the herd when they get to about 15, 16, sometimes even a little bit younger. They just start causing too much chaos, and their testosterone is running, and they run around, they chase small babies, and they're just generally very difficult teenagers. So that's when the females will generally chase them out, and they form smaller bachelor groups, or they just go out on their own. They're still there. We're just going to slide forward. We've got another little one there. It's quite interesting. An elephant bull probably reaches a sexual maturity where he can, where he's physically able to breed at about 15 years old, between sort of 12 and 15. But he will never actually breed till he generally reaches probably around 25, and that's due to the older bulls controlling that situation. So the older bulls will come into must over a certain area at a certain time, and they'll keep the younger bulls from mating till they're actually old enough to compete with the bigger bulls. Yeah, there's definitely some more elephants down below us. We're just going to sit tight right here, even though we can't see them. Those two boys are still sparring in this thicket. And hopefully they'll pop out and give us a bit of a show. Afternoon, Stephen is on Twitter. Stephen would like to know, what is the role of the matriarch, and what does she control within the herd? So basically, the matriarch will be the dominant female in a group of elephants. And basically, she would almost decide where they're going to feed, where they're going to go drink, and those type of things. Elephants aren't a true matriarch. We've been having a few technologies. I know you with Scott, but these Ellies are just having the biggest amount of fun in this drainage line. They're playing. The older bull is actually laid down and was sort of rolling and sort of digging up the ground, and the younger bull's come down the hill. He's sensed he's got a bit of a chance now. He's got the bigger, heavier animal on the floor, but it's not very serious, and they're still playing. Nothing like a bit of teenage rough and tumble. They say boys will be boys. Are we so privileged to be able to witness these animals just in their natural environment and just behaving like elephants should. This one's definitely quite a character. Playing silly buggers. It'd be quite interesting to see if he gets down onto the ground again and gives that smaller one. There we go. Oh, it's almost like he's enticing the smaller, younger animal to come up and wrestle with him by giving him an advantage. Oh, that's magical. Also, nice cool sand after the rain. He might just be having a cool down roll. Something he's probably not going to be able to do when he gets bigger, because once he's a fully grown bull, it's very, very difficult for them to lie down and get up because of that immense weight they have to pick up. And when they do, they'll normally do it against the side of a termite mound or something where he's not completely flat on the ground on an even surface. Oh, there they go again. Let's see how the smaller one is actually spreading his weight there, putting his legs wider to try stop the weight of the older elephant pushing him. I mean, these young boys can play like this for hours on end. And it's when these games sort of get pushed into the females with younger babies that the females start getting very irritated and start pushing these young bulls out of the breeding herds. Okay, we'll just go a little bit forward, try to catch up them. Here they are still. Austin Station, sorry, this is Brent from Wildlife. Scott on the other vehicle is having radio issues. He's with the Zingala at the moment. And then any other updates from here, there's a breeding herd at Gari Dam, or Vuyatela Dam, and some Dugga boys. I couldn't see what he was doing there, Brian. Was he attacking the tree, or is he stuck in the tree and making noise?
Yeah.
Frustrated. So he's got a very funny trumpet for an elephant. Very. This guy likes to crawl around. Now he's lying down in the middle of that quarry thicket, and there comes the younger one again. So I think it's the only way he seems to think, okay, I'm going to carry on this game. I've got to give him an unfair advantage, get him to come up to me when I'm on the ground, and then I can get up and then I can beat him up. Such wonderful behavior they're showing at the moment. Seems to be a lull, a calm before the storm. You'll probably find, I mean, there is a bit of an age difference between these two, but you'll probably find these two young boys have been playing together like this for probably close on 10 years, 12 years even. Just make sure we don't have any elephants sneak up behind us. Slapping him with his trunk. Come on, you can do better than that. Oh, there's an elephant. It's coming up behind us. Another youngster, but he's okay. Alex, do you copy me? Okay, copy. Just checking. I just hadn't heard anything for a while. You guys remember your questions to on Twitter, hashtag Safari Live or questions at wildearth.tv. Afternoon, Georgie from Illinois. Welcome on Drive With Us this afternoon. George, would like to know whether the larger of the elephants has only got a single tusk. She'd like to know how he possibly lost that tusk. Possibly there's a couple of things, but more than likely through play fighting like this, or during feeding, could have broken it on a tree while trying to strip bark. It is quite common for elephants to break tusks. And like people, they are left or right handed, or left or right tusked. So you'll probably find his left tusk, the one that's broken, was the one he used predominantly before that for stripping bark or even possibly sometimes, and would lead in a fight. So that's probably, I think the play fighting, as you can see, he quite likes his play fighting, is probably how he lost that tusk.
He said, I bet you can't push me up.
Yeah. Brian's just saying, if we could understand what elephants say, it's like, I bet you can't get me off the ground. Like teasing your younger cousin. Very strange behavior there. But you are. It's a fork-tailed jongo beating up a hornbill. Normally they do that with birds of prey. Maybe the fork-tailed jongo is blind. The side of the hornbill looks like a predator. The game is not up. Good afternoon, Sharon from Pennsylvania. Welcome on Drive with us today. Sharon would like to know, she heard that when animals play for the sake of play, it's a sign of intelligence. I think the reason a lot of people think that, although this is not play for the sake of play, even though they might just be playing now, it is preparation for in about 10 or 15 years where they are going to have to fight with the other bulls for breeding rights. But play for the sake of play is in terms of intelligence is often because you are in such a safe position, you are not threatened by any other animals, therefore you have the ability to play. I definitely think it is a sign of intelligence, but with a lot of wild animals, it's very difficult to say that they're playing just for the sake of playing. There's always almost a reason for the play that would be sort of, in this case, preparing them for battle when they get older. And same with a lot of your predators, the youngsters, when they play, that's actually preparing them for hunting skills. Oh, guys, unfortunately they've taken their fight right into a thicket, and not even in our really tough vehicles are we going to be able to get in there. So let me just check with Scott, see what's going on there. Alex coming? I'd you like to link to Scott? We've got a zero visual here now. Animals have headed right down into the thickets. Okay, guys, Okay, guys, that was unbelievable, really exciting. Hopefully, we're still going to hang around this area, see if we can find something else. But we're going to link you back to Scott, who's sitting with the lions. So enjoy that, and good luck. Guys, welcome back. It seems like Brian and I are having a very elephant afternoon. We just thought we'd cross across here quickly. It's just such a peaceful and beautiful setting. A small breeding herd drinking here at Buffalo's Hook Dam. And we've also got a whole bunch of hippos down to the right, but to the left. We'll look at them just now. Sort of your quintessential African safari photograph there. Nice little breeding herd drinking, nice late afternoon light. But to go back to finish that story, which we lost when we lost signal, was that after the elephant, I stood up and I threw my rod at it and started throwing sticks and stuff at it. The elephant sort of started backing away and started shouting and clapping my hands. And that managed to push that elephant away. And I was really lucky. The only thing I had was I had a dislocated hip and a couple of bruised ribs. And it could have been much, much worse than that. So I was very, very lucky. And so there's a little baby hippo there sitting on the on his mom's back. It's amazing that the young hippos ran around and managed to stay on top of their parents while in the water. So we had a report earlier on today that there was actually a baby hippo that had been killed in this dam. That's what we were actually coming here to look for. But we can't actually see it at the moment. It might be around the other side of the dam. We will have a look just now, or directly below it. That could have been just during an argument between the adult hippos that the baby just sort of happened to get in the wrong place at the wrong time. Oh. So if you hear a few clicks in the background, it's my camera taking advantage of this great light. It's really soft light. That's one, two, three, I see three baby hippos. You can see here we've got a small breeding herd that doesn't have a lot of young bulls in it. You can see everything's a lot calmer. None of that sort of pandemonium that's associated with teenage elephant bulls. So guys, any questions, just send us an email at questions@wildearth.tv or on Twitter, #SafariLive. Oh, we've got another breeding herd of elephants coming up behind us. So guys, we've just got a breeding herd coming up behind us as well. So it looks like we've got our timing perfect. As the one herd departs, the next one comes in for a drink. Another very small herd. We're just going to sit tight where we are now so we don't disturb them. Nice little baby, hopefully he'll play in the water. Looks like... she's a little bit nervous of us. Looks like she's going to walk around us and come drink opposite us. So, quite often when we have those big groups like we saw earlier this afternoon, that is normally, that'll be two or three family groups. You can see she's not that happy with us. So we'd rather just let her go past and then come around from the other side. Alex, you can go with that question now. Afternoon, Doris is from Maryland. Welcome on Game Drive with us this afternoon. Doris would like to know whether orphaned elephants are cared for by other elephants within the herd. It has been recorded, it does happen, but it doesn't happen that often. Normally if the mother loses the baby or the mother dies or gets separated, the baby will become a nice easy target for a predator. And you do find quite a lot of dead babies in certain parts of the world. So it does happen, but not in every circumstance. It's rather an exception to the rule rather than the rule. There they come. Just see their backs. They're coming around on the road. And you've got the others departing on the road. Very civilized elephants we have here in the Sabi Sands. guys. There we go. Now she comes. There we go. There's a little one coming through. Bro, do you think if I move back a bit, you have a better shot? Are you happy where you are?
Should be good, yeah.
Do really enjoy spending time with Ellie's. Go ahead, Alex. You can go with the questions. Afternoon, Anise from Connecticut. Anise would like to know whether the hippos give birth on the water or on the land. What will happen when a female hippo is ready to give birth, she will generally move to a shallow section of water, maybe very, very shallow, or a big reed bed that's just out of the water. So it's sort of right on the edge of the water, in very shallow water, is where hippos give birth. So the trick is, from photography, you want to try to get all three of them with their trunks cold at the same time. Doesn't happen too often. So we got two that time. Out of sync. So an adult elephant she can probably drink up to about 60 litres of water in a day. They can go for more than one day without water, but generally if they have the choice, they will drink every day, sometimes twice a day. Let's see the young baby there, he's learned how to use his trunk now. He still doesn't have as much control as the older ones, but you can see he has learned the fundamentals of being able to drink with his trunk and stuff like that. And you see he doesn't fit under his mom's belly anymore, so he's probably just over, actually probably 14 to 16 months old now. Just magical. We're very lucky to be able to just sit here and enjoy this. Yeah, the hippos in the background. And we'll be getting ready to head out foraging in an hour or so once it gets dark. Thirsty Ellie's. amazing dexterity in that elephant's trunk. Playing, just fiddling with his trunk in the water. It's always funny when you see young elephants going uphill, it always seems to be like three times harder than it should be. Oh, he's charging the bird. He just chased the dove. Just making sure the dove knows he's in charge. Big scary elephant, ears out,
chest up, head lifted.
Eileen from Boston. Boston would like to know what the definition of a breeding herd of elephants. Well, basically, Eileen, it would be elephants that have sub-adults, or be an adult, sub-adults, maybe some babies. Even though that's a very small breeding herd, there's three different ages there, and that female is a breeding female, therefore that is a breeding herd. You probably find that she might be separated from a slightly larger family group, but that's why she was a bit nervous when she came past her. She could even be part of that family group that left and she'll listening or by smell tracking them. But the only other type of herd, you do get bachelor herds of elephants. And I was talking about earlier in the drive, those young bulls sort of between the ages of about 14 and 20 that are pushed out of the breeding herds, and they form bachelor groups because they feel safer when they're all together. And guys, it was really, really great to share that little sizing with you. And we're going to head back to Scott shortly because I just heard that he's back with the lions. Hopefully they're doing something more interesting than they were earlier. I heard they were just sleeping. But we'll go back to Scott. So guys, we just come down the road further and there's two separate groups of eddies that were drinking at the dam. As I said, it looked like she might be part of a larger herd. She's actually come and joined up with the other herd that was drinking originally. Sorry guys, I'm just going to move back a little bit because that's a young boy there and he can get his mother worked up, and that's what we don't want. So we'll just slowly freewheel back down the hill. Just give them a little bit of space, because the problem with young Eddie bulls like that, especially that age, he's going to come, he might get his mother worked out by charging the vehicle to prove how tough he is. Cheeky. See, he's throwing a stick at us. Oh, we've been really lucky with elephant sightings this afternoon, guys. It's been really, really incredible. Oh, we're having a scratch at the back there. There's two little boys having fights right at the back. Two little guys. See, we're quite lucky. This is what we get for our afternoon rush hour traffic jam.
The worst.
The worst traffic jam ever. I mean, who would want to sit here? No, look at him. always with elephant herds, you just got to be careful that you don't get encircled by them. Very distinct tusks on that female there. He's practicing to use his trunk by throwing leaves and sticks.
It's actually a nice shot at the back of the family. Oh. Okay.
Yeah, Alex, so you can go back to Scott. I'll leave these elephants and go around and see if we can find something else. So we just heard over the radio that the lions have begun to play and stuff like that. So, sorry, 1 minute. Stay with the Ellie's a little bit longer. Okay, she's how she's resting her head against the possibly her son, the young male. But just by the looks of her body size and stuff like that, without watching them for a lot longer, I would possibly say that she is the matriarch of this little family unit. Oh. Using her son's problem is a scratching post. Okay, so the lions have started to play, guys, so we're going to cross over to Scott. And I hope you enjoyed the Ellies, and now you can go enjoy some lions.